I almost got lost.
Thank you very much.
What was going on?
You can Google Peace Poets. Look at that.
There you go.
Oye mi gente, traemos la fuerza.
Oye mi gente, traemos la fuerza.
La libertad es la única bandera.
La libertad es la única bandera.
Rise up my people, my condor, my ego.
Rise up my people, my condor, my ego.
No human being can be illegal.
No human being can ever be illegal.
Oye mi gente, traemos la fuerza.
Oye mi gente, traemos la fuerza.
La libertad es la única bandera.
La libertad es la única bandera.
Rise up my people, my condor, my ego.
Rise up my people, my condor, my ego.
No human being is ever illegal.
No human being is ever illegal.
Oye mi gente, traemos la fuerza.
Oye mi gente, traemos la fuerza.
La libertad es mi única bandera.
La libertad es la única bandera.
Rise up my people, my condor, my ego.
Rise up my people, my condor, my ego.
No human being can ever be illegal.
No human being can ever be illegal.
Oye mi gente, traemos la fuerza.
Oye mi gente, traemos la fuerza.
La libertad es la única bandera.
La libertad es la única bandera.
Rise up my people, my condor, my ego.
Rise up my people, my condor, my ego.
No human being can ever be illegal.
No human being can ever be illegal.
I just want to say thank you so much to Finding Our Voices and Amerta and Joe or Josh. We're incredible. It's actually so meaningful to do this in song because it's very difficult to put into words certainly what probably many of us feel when we track this issue. I'm Laura with the Children's Defense Fund, and I'm one of the co-hosts for today's event. It's a Saturday night, there's other events going. We're small, but we are a mighty, mighty crowd. I would bet that every single one of you does a lot for our community and for our collective humanity every day, and I really wanna thank you for everything you do every day. We have just a very short program with you today. Two speakers, Pastor Mary Street Wilson, and I'm getting nervous in front of crowds, but Kate Lincoln Goldfinch, who's an immigration attorney here in Austin and is working with affected families every day. I'm gonna pass the moment to them and then we can turn it back to song, which for me is the most meaningful part. But please sign up for the sign-up sheets going around, because one of the things I'm most interested in this event is how, like all of these actions, it's not just one day. But how do we keep working together and multiply our actions? And the only way we can do that is if we can communicate with each other. If you sign up, the Children's Defense Fund in Family Separation and Detention, Voto Latino, Indivisible Austin, and others that are working on this, we want to organize us so that we are a laser-focused powerhouse. Every week, we all do one action together. You know, can we get 100 emails to Governor Abbott? Can we get 100 emails to, you know, each of these decision makers that are going? That will be noticed. It doesn't take a lot of us to do something noticeable, but it does take us to be aligned. And so please sign up for the sign-up sheets going around, and we'll do another pitch at the end, but without further ado, please, Pastor Mary Street Wilson, give us something to reflect on.
Absolutely. Yeah. Thank you all for being here. Thank you all for being here. And since we did a peace poet song, let me do one more thing from peace poets that I got to hear them do in person a couple of years ago. And it goes something like this: my liberation is your liberation is my liberation is your liberation. And over and over and over, we are not free if people are in cages. We are not free when children are in cages. We are not free when people are hungry. We are not free when racism exists. We are not free, because my liberation is your liberation, is their liberation, is our liberation together. We are not free until all are free.
That's right.
Woo! So, as you may see, the stole I'm wearing tonight represents many faith traditions, represents the LGBTQIA community. We are all in this together. We are all in this together, and every faith tradition, every moral movement, every person with a conscience recognizes some variation of do unto others as you would have done unto you. And if I am hungry, if I am alone, if I am in need, I want people who will give a damn about me. And that is what we are here to do. You are here because you care about what's happening to those people who are complete strangers to us. But in my faith tradition, as many other faith traditions, caring for the stranger is our ultimate calling. We cannot turn a blind eye. Those who are hungry, we're supposed to feed. Those who are in jail, we're supposed to visit. Those who need housing, we're supposed to house. Those who need clothing, we're supposed to clothe. And there is no, but what if they're not, you know, from my space. Let me share with you one story that many people do not recognize or hear often from our Christian text. Jesus was at the beach, basically, on a vacation from all the work he was doing. And a Canaanite woman, a foreign woman to him, came up to him and said, "My daughter is sick. I need you to heal her." And he says, "Get away from me. I'm tired. Just get away. You're not my people. I'm not here for you." And she persisted and said, "But yes, you are. Because even those of us who get the crumbs from the table, don't we deserve even those crumbs?" And Jesus paused and he looked at her and acknowledged that she was right. And in that moment, the other to Jesus taught him something about his very own purpose. That is who we want to be. That is who we need to be. Not only modeling those of us who identify as Christians, modeling who we believe Jesus to be, but modeling those who taught him something about who he was supposed to be. Let us do that together. Let us care about one another. Let us recognize that when my children and my grandchildren have enough to eat, that somebody else doesn't. When my children, my grandchildren have a good education, somebody else doesn't. But that doesn't mean that we shouldn't work towards that. The other is really not an other. Because my liberation is your liberation, is their liberation, is my liberation, is our liberation together. Thank you all for being here. Appreciate it very much.
My name is Kate Lincoln Goldfish. I own an immigration law firm in Austin, and I have done asylum law for over 10 years.
Thank you.
In the summer of 1939, a German ocean liner called the St. Louis, which was carrying over 900 Jews fleeing the Holocaust, docked in Miami. They were turned away by U.S. officials and forced to return home, where over a quarter of them died in the Holocaust. Let's see if I can do. How's this?
Yeah.
After the failure of the U.S. and the world to protect Jews during World War II, the United Nations created an international treaty called the 1951 Refugee Convention.
Yeah, that'd be great.
In which the countries recognize their responsibility to offer safety,
refuge and hospitality to individuals fleeing persecution. In 1980, we created laws regarding asylum. Section 208 of the Immigration and Nationality Act says, any alien who is physically present in the United States or who arrives in the United States, irrespective of such alien status, may apply for asylum. For over 7 decades, the United States has allowed individuals to apply for asylum in the United States. We have a prescribed system and method to process asylum seekers. We put them through a credible fear interview where they must prove their eligibility for asylum. If they pass, they get to live and work in the United States while they await their court hearings. If they fail, they get one appeal and are sent home if unsuccessful. While not perfect, the system works. The United States government processes, on average, 7,000 asylum seekers every month. The caravan of asylum seekers represents a typical number of asylum seekers that are processed every month. The Trump administration wants its followers to believe this is a horde, an invasion. This is fear-mongering rhetoric calculated to stir up the xenophobic supporters of the Trump administration. It is the Trump administration who is breaking the law by not allowing migrants the chance to apply for asylum. These asylum seekers have left everything behind, their homes, their possessions, their families and friends, in order to get themselves and their children to safety. They are fleeing unchecked gang violence, murder, and rape. The children are the most vulnerable to violence, as are the family members who try to protect them. Multiple studies have shown that asylum seekers who pass a credible fear interview are more than 90% likely to come to their final hearings. And why wouldn't they? If they don't attend, they get deported. But if they do, they can win their case and stay in the United States. Yet the Trump administration wants to detain asylum seekers indefinitely. Why? I know why. There is one entity that benefits from the detention of asylum seekers, and that is the private prison companies, who earn millions of dollars a day on the detention of migrants, and who pay millions of dollars a year in campaign contributions to politicians who turn around and indefinitely detain migrants. I represent a woman named Griselda, who has been in immigration detention for over 1 year, separated from her U.S. citizen child, who is 6, just like my daughter, Nora. Griselda was picked up by ICE when her abuser called them. She has audio recordings of her daughter telling her that her father is abusing her. He has cut off contact with Griselda and she remains in custody. She's not a flight risk. She's not a danger to our community. It is our civic duty to speak out against injustices like these, and we must continue our vigilance and outrage against the treatment of migrants. I urge you to support the organizations that are doing important work to help immigrants. A wise woman named Virginia Raymond recently reminded me that adversity is an opportunity for heroism. When we look back at the heroes of our past, the Underground Railroad, the people hiding Jews in their homes during the Holocaust, Rosa Parks, MLK, the Little Rock Nine, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, all were brave people who spoke up and did hard work when things seemed hopeless. You are all heroes in your own time. So keep it up and don't give up. Thank you.
Hey guys, I'm Kristen. I run the In Family Separation and Detention Facebook group. If you've got a flashlight, turn it on now. I think it's dark enough to be kind of pretty. So I was supposed to get up and just talk about one little thing on our flashlights, which I'll definitely do that, but I want to say a little more if that's okay. So I don't know how you guys feel right now, but I feel like garbage. I'm heartbroken. I'm beyond heartbroken. I was heartbroken in May. And I couldn't believe that we lived in a society that could turn a blind eye to this. And it's so heartwarming to, on a Monday, hear about the horrors that were happening at our border on the Sunday, and put something together and literally in days have you all here. So I just want to thank you all for being here. I want to thank you all for being here, and I want to thank you all for continuing to fight for something that isn't glamorous and has a lot of pushback. I want to encourage every single one of you to go to your communities and have hard conversations. That's with not just your crotchety uncle at the Christmas dinner table or the Hanukkah table, but that's with your friends that you might not have talked to since high school that think, well, they threw rocks at the border, so, you know, of course they're gonna get gassed. Those are the people that we need to be winning right now. We need to win hearts and minds of people every day because we are on the right side of history. And this won't last forever because people like you and I will not let it last forever. So please become a part of my community online if you're able. If you've got a Facebook account, please join. If there's anything I can do to help you facilitate those conversations, I want to do it. Personally for me, when I went over my mother, that is when I feel like I will have succeeded in some small way. So we all have those people. If you got a flashlight that we provided for you, there's a little sticky on it that says text the word resist to 50409, and it will prompt you so that you can directly message your legislators through text message. It's super, super easy. I hate making phone calls. It intimidates me. The idea of calling a legislator to ask them to stand up for something, it unnerves me. It makes me want to vomit. So if you're like me and you're a chicken, then this is an easy way to do that. So if you are able, please do that once a day, every day until this is over. I get up every morning, I brush my teeth, and I do it. It's super easy. If you didn't get a flashlight, grab 5 on your way out and give them to that crotchety uncle. So anyway, I thank you for being here. I thank you for being an ally. That's all.
And we thank you, Kristen. Yay!
So we're gonna hang out here. As you talk to people in your community and convince them that this is an important issue to stand up for, it's the issue of our humanity, really. Is there any more important reason to stand up? Get them to sign up for the link you're gonna get. Once you sign up on our sign-up sheet, we will email you, and there will be a way where you can get more and more people connected, or through Kristen's Facebook page. Second is the resist piece, and I think the third is just don't give up. We got to keep working on this until it's over. And with that, Josh and Martha, would y'all mind taking it away again?
Javier,
your team,
Javier, sing
yes.
A song for us. And then we'll sing at least one or a few more after that. But let's have a song.
Juliana, one song. I don't know if you know it, but the lyrics are beautiful. Maybe close, okay? They can listen to the words. It's by Violeta Parra. She was from Chile.
Coming close.
Fantastic songwriter and theater poet and everything you can think of when it comes to the arts as applied to political activism. Violeta Parra is still an icon in Latin America and throughout the world. One of his most beautiful songs was called Volver a los 17 and talks about the power of love. So the song is called Volver a los 17.
Volver a los 17 después de vivir un siglo es como descifrar signos sin ser sabio competente. Volver a ser de repente tan frágil como un segundo. Volver a sentir profundo como un niño frente a Dios. Eso es lo que siento yo en este instante fecundo. Se va enredando como en el muro la grieta, y va brotando como el musguito en la piedra, como el musguito en la piedra. Y sí, mi paso retrocedido. Cuando el ustedes avanza, el arco de las alianzas ha penetrado en mí. Con todo su colorido se ha paseado por mis venas, y hasta la dura cadena con que nos ata el destino es como un diamante fino que alumbra mi alma serena. está brotando, brotando, como el mosquito en la piedra, como el mosquito en la piedra, y sí, sí, sí. El amor es torbellino, de puro es originario, hasta el feroz animal susurra su dulce trino, detiene a los peregrinos, libera a los prisioneros, el amor con sus esmeros, al viejo lo vuelve niño, y al malo solo el cariño, lo vuelve puro y sincero. Se va enredando, enredando, como en el muro la hiedra, y va brotando, brotando, como el musguito en la piedra, como el mosquito en la piedra, y sí, sí, sí. El amor es torbellino, de puro es original, hasta el feroz animal susurra su dulce trino, detiene a los peregrinos, libera a los prisioneros, el amor con sus esmeros, al viejo lo vuelve niño, y al malo solo el cariño, lo vuelve puro y sincero. Se va enredando, enredando, como en el muro cañera, y va brotando, brotando, como el mosquito en la piedra, como el mosquito en la piedra, y sí, sí, sí. Par en par la ventana se abrió como por encanto, entró el amor con su manto como una tibia mañana, y al son de su bella diana hizo brotar el jazmín, volando cual serafín al cielo le puso arete, y mis años en 17 los convirtió en querubín. Se va enredando, enredando, como en el muro la hiedra, y va brotando, brotando, como el mosquito en la piedra, como el mosquito en la piedra, y sí, sí, sí. Como el mosquito en la piedra, y sí, sí, sí. Como el mosquito en la piedra, y sí, sí, sí.